Hello everyone, welcome to my channel My Biology Mantra. This video is specially made for the students preparing for ISC Board Biology exam. As we know that ISC Board is totally following CBSE Board syllabus since 2018, and even the question paper pattern is also same for both the boards. In most of the ISC Board schools for classes 11 and 12, they are using Nootan book from Nageen Prakashan, but it contains extra stuff for information and which will not be useful for the board exam last minute study. And as we know that very few days are left, so we have to target what will come in board exam. So today I have started a series for ISC Biology class 12 students, those who are preparing for board exam, and so that they know what to read from this book to obtain 100% marks and what portion they can leave. So let's start our first chapter, Reproduction in Organism. So this is the first chapter, Reproduction in Organism, and as you can see, this is the elaboration of the syllabus, and this syllabus is exactly similar to CBSE board syllabus. तो हमें इस बात को ध्यान में रखना है. लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर. देखिए, इस नूतन बुक में कुछ चीजें बहुत ही इलैबोरेट करके दी हुई हैं, कुछ टॉपिक्स को जो कि जरूरत नहीं है, और कुछ चीजें मिसिंग भी हैं जो कि उनका डिस्क्रिप्शन क्वेश्चन आंसर्स के फॉर्म में है, बट इन थ्योरी इट इज मिसिंग. सो वी शुड राइट इट एट देयर, एंड जो ज्यादा दिया हुआ है उसको हमें छोड़ देना है. सो लेट्स बिगिन द चैप्टर. द पीरियड फ्रॉम बर्थ टू द नेचुरल डेथ ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म रिप्रेजेंट्स इट्स लाइफ स्पैन. ये ध्यान रखेंगे कि लाइफ स्पैन जो है इज नॉट नेसेसरली कोरिलेटेड विद द साइजेस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म. जैसे कि क्रो एंड पैरेट बोथ हैव ऑलमोस्ट सेम साइजेस, बट देयर लाइफ स्पैन इज टोटली डिफरेंट. क्रो 15 इयर्स एंड पैरेट 140 इयर्स. सेम साइजेस बट डिफरेंट लाइफ स्पैन. सो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, डेथ ऑफ एवरी इंडिविजुअल ऑर्गेनिज्म इज सर्टेन. नो इंडिविजुअल इज इमोर्टल एक्सेप्ट सिंगल सेल्ड ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक दैट अमीबा. व्हाई दे आर इमोर्टल अमीबा और एनी अदर सिंगल सेल्ड ऑर्गेनिज्म? बिकॉज दे डिस्ट्रीब्यूट और डिवाइड एंड देयर साइटोप्लाज्म टू देयर डॉटर सेल्स एंड कंटिन्यू टू लिव एज डॉटर सेल्स. This is the definition of reproduction. I will give you the exact definition of it. Reproduction is a biological process. It is a biological process to give rise to similar offspring. Or reproduction is a biological process to give rise to offspring of your own kind. So this is the exact definition. The chief objective of reproduction therefore is perpetuation of the species, consequently increase the number of individual, or you can say it maintains or enables continuity of species from one generation to the next generation. So this is the exact thing. Now this is the approximate lifespan of some organism given. See, this thing you have to learn very thoroughly. इसको अच्छी तरीके से आपको learn करना है, क्योंकि short question में इसमें से एक question आ सकता है. आप इसे increasing order में इस तरीके से बना लेंगे और इसे अच्छे से learn कर लेंगे. Like that, this I have made it for you. Lifespan of some organism: butterfly 1 to 2 weeks, fruit fly 40 to 50 days, rice plant 3 to 7 months, rose plant 6 to 10 years, crow and cow 15 years, banana 25 years, dog 20 to 30, crocodile and horse 60, elephant 70 to 90, man 80 years, parrot 140 years, tortoise 100 to 150 years, banana 200 years. So in this way you can learn. So after this chart comes to mode of reproduction. See, the organism habitat, its internal physiology and several other factors are collectively responsible for how it reproduces. Or in other words, you can say ki reproduction jo hai wo depend karta hai organism ke habitat kaisi hai, uski internal physiology kaisi hai, aur baki aur bhi bahut sare factors hai, like that genetic makeup kaisa hai. In this, in general, plants can reproduce by vegetative, asexual and sexual processes. Tino hi processes se plant reproduce karta hai. Vegetative reproduction are all those processes in which a part of the plant body is separated from the parent and give rise to new individuals. So this is the definition of vegetative reproduction. See, in general you can say there are two types of reproduction: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Actually, this vegetative reproduction is the part of asexual reproduction. Okay, now come to asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, in asexual reproduction only single parent is involved, or you can say a single organism is capable of producing of its own kind, and the individual produces genetically similar to or identical to it, to their or exact copy to their parents. जो भी इंडिविजुअली ऑफस्प्रिंग प्रोड्यूस होते हैं ड्यूरिंग एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन में, वो एक्जैक्टली सिमिलर होते हैं. दे आर मॉर्फोलॉजिकली एंड जेनेटिकली सिमिलर टू देयर पेरेंट. दैट्स व्हाई दे आर नोन एज क्लोन. सो डेफिनेशन ऑफ क्लोन इज डिस्क्राइब्ड एज मॉर्फोलॉजिकली एंड जेनेटिकली सिमिलर इंडिविजुअल. दिस इज गिवन इन सिलेबस, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. examples of reproduction, asexual reproduction, it is mostly the characteristic feature of the lower organisms such as protozoans, sponges, coelenterates, and other certain flatworms. Now come to type of asexual reproduction. Number one is fission. It is one of the most common method of asexual reproduction in unicellular algae, fungi, protozoans, and several other metazoans. The body of the organism, after attaining a certain size, simply divides into two or more parts, and each part having a part of the nucleus. And there are two types of fission: binary fission and multiple fission. This is binary fission. Binary fission. In binary fission, two individuals are formed from single parent, and this may be irregular. कहीं से भी body divide हो सकती, like that in amoeba. Transverse plane only the body, when body can divide into transverse plane, like that in paramecium, and longitudinal like that euglena. Only these is required. इसके अलावा इसके हमें और ज़्यादा इसका topic को elaborate नहीं करना है. In amoeba, this is given in your syllabus. They may ask, write down the binary fission in amoeba. In amoeba, or it is a protozoa, two daughter amoebae are formed by the division of parent amoeba. The division involves nuclear division followed by cytoplasmic division. As the daughter amoebae grow, they repeat the same cycle of binary fission. With diagram you should do. Ye diagram ke saath mein. See, this is the amoeba, parent amoeba nucleus. This is the nucleus, elongated. Elongation of the nucleus, further nuclear divided into two part, and this cell foroforms, and then it divides, cytoplasm also divided into two daughter amoeba. So this is a whole diagram. With this theory you should do. Next part. See, this is also in syllabus, that binary fission in paramecium. So in paramecium, transverse binary fission occur. During fission, the macronucleus divides amitotically, means anywhere irregular, and micronucleus mitotically, means all the stages like metaphase, anaphase, telophase, stages of the mitosis, and the products of these division are two macronuclei and two micronuclei. One pair, one macro and one micronuclei goes to anterior part and the other to the posterior part. Finally, a constriction appear to the middle of the body and form the two daughter paramecia. So this thing you can do. You can do the diagram also. इसको आप diagram के साथ कर लेंगे. They may ask the explain the binary fission in paramecium. So this is macronucleus, this is macronucleus, micronucleus, contractile vacuole, oral groove, later on oral groove disappear, macronucleus divide amitotically and macronucleus divide mitotically, and new oral grooves are formed. These two oral grooves are formed and cell farrow begins, and then new contractile vacuole forms here. And then it divided into two daughter paramecia. So this along with diagram you should do this description. Then leave this portion, plane A, this part, it is not required. These diagrams are not required, not given anywhere. Euglena, this part is not required. This is required. Multiple fission, in multiple fission the parent body divided into many daughter organisms, or as in amoeba, Plasmodium vivax, it is malarial parasite. See, this is important phenomenon. Multiple fission occurs in during unfavorable condition in amoeba. During unfavorable environmental condition, amoeba reproduces by multiple fission and it secretes a three-layered protective chitinous cyst around it and becomes inactive. This three-layered formation is known as incestation. You can write here. इसे क्या बोलते हैं? इसे incestation. इस process को बोलते हैं incestation. Incestation. You can write. This process is incestation. Okay, and then the nucleus divides repeatedly to form daughter nuclei, which arrange themselves near the periphery, and each daughter nucleus is enveloped by a small amount of cytoplasm and thus forming amoebae. Amoebae here, and or you can say write simply here that inactive, and becomes inactive, and thus when favorable condition comes, you can add here. When favorable condition comes, the nucleus divide repeatedly. So just add when favorable condition comes. When favorable condition returns, it divide by multiple fission. So when favorable condition comes, it divides by multiple fission. The nucleus divides repeatedly to form several daughter nuclei. Several daughter nuclei. Okay. Up to here only. Several daughter nuclei. And each daughter nuclei is enveloped by a small amount of cytoplasm, thus forming a amoebial or pseudopodiospore. Okay. This process is known as
sporulation. This process is known as sporulation. And return of the favorable condition, the cyst breaks off and young one amoebae grow into the new amoeba. When cyst wall breaks, it liberates the young spores and which grow into mature amoeba. And this phenomena is known as sporulation. So these two terms must be there, incestation and sporulation. Okay, now come to bi-budding. It is the most common method of reproduction in lower organism. East budding in yeast is given in your syllabus. In yeast cell, the protoplast bulges out in the form of bud that grow eventually and separated from the mother cell. And up to here only, mother cell, from here to here. And in Hydra is also given. In Hydra, a bulge appears in the middle of the posterior part of the body as a result of repeated multiplication of epidermal interstitial cell, and the wall of outgrowth is called bud. And this the bud gradually grows in size and develops a mouth and circlet of tentacles. It's free and then it gets detached from the parent body. So this is the, and eventually develop into the independent organism. Only this lines you should do. This is the Hydra, budding in Hydra. They may ask, write down the, explain the budding in Hydra or explain the budding in East. For East, this diagram, you must do this diagram. You should do this diagram from A to E. This is the diagram budding in East. And this is the diagram of budding in Hydra. You must do these two diagrams. See, what is the difference between binary fission and multiple fission? They may ask. Binary fission, parent cell divides into two halves, or each grows into an adult. Whereas in multiple fission, parent cell divides into many identical daughter cells. This is the basic difference. Okay, now come to multiple fission in. Type of asexual reproduction is by gemmule formation. See this gemmule formation. It is internal budding, example of internal budding, and it is asexual reproductive structure or spores. This is the very important terms. So all freshwater and some marine sponges reproduce asexually by the formation of specialized endogenous buds. These are not exogenous, endogenous, and known as gemmules. And in freshwater sponges, the gemmules are formed by the accumulation of archaeocyte cells laden with food reserve material. This is the only thing. And in favorable conditions, the gemmule germinates and produces a new sponge. This is the diagram. This is gemmule, these are archaeocyte cells, these are spicule. They will not ask to draw a diagram, but still you should know. Regeneration is not in your syllabus, but you should know the definition. Some lower organism like Hydra, starfish, planaria have great power of replacement or regeneration of lost part. And this phenomena is known as regeneration. Now come to the differentiate between sexual and asexual reproduction. See, asexual reproduction, there is no mixing of genetic material because only single parent is involved here. Whereas in sexual reproduction, two gametes, male and female gametes are involved, so that there is mixing of genetic material and it creates variation or evolution. In asexual reproduction, no gamete formation takes place, but in sexual reproduction, gametes are formed. In asexual reproduction, more offsprings are produced, and these offsprings are genetically and morphologically similar to their parents. They are clones. Whereas sexual reproduction, no clone formation and very fewer offspring with hybrid, or you can say hybrid offspring with some variation are formed. Only one parent is involved. In this, two parents are involved of opposite sexes. Asexual reproduction is rapid process, or it is fast process, and whereas sexual reproduction, it is slower process as compared to asexual process. And this is a simple process, this is elaborated and complex process. Now come to fragmentation. This is given in your syllabus. In filamentous algae like Eulothrix and Spirogyra, the thallus often breaks and into small fragments, and each fragment has the capability to grow independently into a new thallus. So you can write a definition that when parental body breaks into
pieces or fragments, and each fragment develop into new individual, then it is, this process is known as fragmentation. This is a type of asexual mode of reproduction. For example, fragmentation in Hydra. You can write a fragmentation in Hydra. This is the example. Hydra is also example. Hydra. Fragmentation in Hydra. Now come to the spores. See some simple plants such as algae. Some simple plants such as algae reproduce through sexual reproductive structure, and you can say asexual reproductive structure. And these are known as spores through special asexual reproductive structures. You should write asexual reproductive structures. And the most common of these structures are variety of motile zoospores or non-motile, like that conidia. In your syllabus, conidia is given. Conidia is given. And spores which germinate directly to form new individuals. For example, so two types of spores is given. Spores are asexual reproductive structures. See, zoospores in chlamydomonas is given in your syllabus. You can do in chlamydomonas and unicellular alga, zoospores are formed under during favorable condition, and at the time of zoospore formation, the cell withdraws its flagella and become non-motile, and its protoplast divides into longitudinally to form 4 to 8 uninucleate protoplasts within the parent cell wall, and each of these protoplasts secrete a wall around its cell and develops a flagella. And these flagellated daughter cells are known as zoospores. Only this much you have to do. Okay, zoospores. What is zoospores? The most important line are, these are, this is the main important type. What is zoospores? These are asexual reproductive structures. You should write this. For example, in chlamydia, these are asexual reproductive, you can say motile structures. Motile structures or spores. These are asexual reproductive or motile structures or spores. Okay, this is the exact definition of zoospore. And why this diagram you can see. Only they will not tell you how to form on this. Only this diagram. See, flagella is there. This is the chlamydomonas, and there is a withdraw its flagella, and then protoplast divides into many times, and then it forms many zoospores. So these each one have flagella. That's why they are motile. Now come to conidia. Asexual spore conidia is also there. Conidia is in your syllabus. Sporangia spore is also there, but you need not to do it. This is conidia 4. This is this diagram you have to do. Diagram number D. In which this conidia are there. See this conidia. See, this one is internal endogenous spores. These are, you can write here anywhere. These are endogenous spores. These develops inside the body, endogenous spores, okay, internal spores, whereas conidia is exogenous. These are exogenous spores. And which type of spores? Asexual reproductive spores, or you can say structures or units. Okay, now move to next part. What is conidia? It is given, conidia develops on conidia. They are also known as conidia spores, are found many different groups of fungi, and they produced exogenously on conidia 4. Example, aspergillus or penicillium. This is the exact. They will ask conidia, or they may ask differentiate between zoospores or conidia. So what is the difference between zoospore and conidia? Zoospores are, conidia are, you can write here, conidias are non-motile. Non-motile exogenous asexual reproductive structures. This is the exact definition. Example, this one is more important. Penicillium. Okay. Now come to vegetative reproduction in plant. This is also one of the type of asexual reproduction. The question may ask why it is a type of asexual reproduction, because in vegetative reproduction also clones are formed.
The offsprings are genetically and morphologically similar to their parents as well as to each other. That's why they are clone, and clone is formed in asexual reproduction. So that's why they comes under the, this vegetative propagation comes under the category of asexual reproduction. And this vegetative propagation is actually a type of asexual reproduction present in plants only. Okay, what is this? It is regeneration of new plant from a part of vegetative organ. What are vegetative organ? These vegetative organs are leaf, stem, root, or any part of root, types of root, underground stem, underground root, like that. Regeneration of new plants from a part of vegetative organ like leaf, stem, root, these are called vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation. See here, it is, they have given stem, roots and leaves of flowering plants are variously modified to bring about vegetative reproduction. So this is the exact definition. One more term is there, that is vegetative propagule. You can write here vegetative propagule. So vegetative propagules are, what are vegetative propagules? Are the parts of plant. Parts of plant like stem, root and leaf, you can say, which can give rise to new plant. Which can give rise to new plant. This you have to add. So vegetative propagules are nothing but the that part of plant which like stem, root or leaf which can give rise to new plant. So this is the definition of vegetative propagation, and this is the type of, you can add here, it is a type of asexual mode of, it is a type of asexual mode of reproduction. Type of asexual reproduction in plants. Asexual reproduction in plants. Now come to underground stem. You know that some of the stem, root or leaves are modified so that they can propagate vegetatively, like that underground stem. So example of vegetative, this rhizome is given. Rhizome in your book also given. It is rhizome. So rhizomes are thick prostrate underground stem which grows horizontally beneath the soil surface. Under the soil surface they grow horizontally. See, it is inside the soil. This is the soil and inside it grows horizontally. It is more elongated as compared to its length. So many plants are economic like ginger and turmeric as well as banana. It is given. Ginger and banana are more important. Are the example of rhizome. Directly come to next. Tuber are modified underground stem develops as a result of accumulation of reserve food material at the tip of branches as in potato, like in Solanum tuberosum. This is tuber. See, this is the tuber, tip is swollen and it develops into new plant. Actually the eyes, you can add now, eyes of bird, eyes have bud which can give rise to new plant. Bulbs are actually, when we want, if you want to propagate plant from rhizome, so you should propagate, you should cut rhizome into pieces and should take in each piece contain at least one axillary bud. Similarly, if you want to propagate plant from tuber, so you should cut potato in such a way that it must contain eye, because eye contain this part, eye, this black portion, eye is there. This contain adventitious bud. Now come to bulb. This bulb refers to short and thickened underground stem axis. It presents a convex or slightly conical disc like that onion. And onion is also there. Lily is also there. See, but this is the bulb. Disc is formed there. Disc is there. And this garlic is also there. These are the corm is not given in your course. This corm is exactly it is also underground stem and it is exactly similar to rhizome which contains nodes and internodes, but it is horizontally more elaborated. Okay, like that corn in colocasia. Come to subaerial stem. It is given runner. Runner is given in your syllabus. So you can write runner is a slender prostrate subaerial stem that creeps horizontally on the surface of soil. For example, in dhub grass, grass is given. See, this is the diagram of runner. No need to learn diagram, only just see how runner is there. See, from wherever it touches in the ground, the adventitious roots comes out. Now come to offset. Offset is given. Offset is a short, stout, thick and slender condensed runner, you can say, that originate The axil of leaf and elongates on to a very limited extent. The apex of the branches gets curved and produces a cluster of leaves above and tuft of adventitious root below. So the branches break only this much. This is the diagram of offset. It is like runner, but its node and internodes are internode distance is very less. Okay, and this is important thing. Example of this is water hyacinth or E. cornea. Some other points of water hyacinths are also there. You should remember it. It is the most invasive weed. Somewhere it may be written in book. It is the most invasive weed. Most invasive weed. It is also known as scourge of water bodies. It is also known as terror of Bengal. It is most invasive weed, scourge of water bodies, terror of Bengal, and it grows in standing water. It grows in standing water. Some other points also. It drains, you just write points about water hyacinth. Write water hyacinth here. Water hyacinth here. And write these points. These points are very important. Water hyacinth drains oxygen from water bodies. Drains oxygen from water bodies and leads to the death of fishes. Leads to deaths of fishes. And water hyacinth, another point about water hyacinth, it propagates means badhta hai. It propagates vegetatively. It propagates vegetatively at phenomenal rate. Bahut hi teji se. At phenomenal rate and spread all over the water bodies. Spread all over the water bodies. Then last point is, which is also very important, it is introduced in India. Why it is introduced? Due to its beautiful leaves. You can say flowers, beautiful flowers and shapes of leaves. That's why it is introduced in India. Okay, so this is the important, some other points of water hyacinth which is important for exam point of view. Now come to sucker. Sucker is a type of subaerial branch that arises from the basal underground portion of the main stem. Initially it grows horizontally below the surface. Initially it grows below the, under the surface. Later on it comes out obliquely upward from the leafy shoot. And this example is mint, or which is given in your syllabus is pineapple. Pineapple is important example. Pineapple and mint. These two examples you should learn. Diagrams are not required. See this diagram. You can see, just learn and see this. Initially it grows inside the soil and obliquely it comes upward. So this is the diagram. Stolon is not given in your syllabus. Now come to roots you can do. It is not given, but from roots also plants can propagate. Like that tuberous root of sweet potato, asparagus. The adventitious bud that develop into new plants. Leaves is given in bryophyllum or calancho. Foliar buds must be there. Foliar buds produce on the leaf margin. Leaf margin, foliar buds produce, which grows into new plants. And this is the example. Some given example, leaf margin is given. Diagrams are not required. Now come to next. This is the diagram. You can see vegetative propagation by leaves in bryophyllum. See the notches, foliar buds are produced from which the propagate. Bulbil of agave, it is very important. This C diagram, this is the bulbil of agave. This is the C1. This is the diagram agave. This term you have to learn. This in this agave, what happened? Reproductive bulbs or bulbil often takes place, many flowers on the inflorescence, and the main thing is in the lower part of the inflorescence are modified into multicellular structures called bulbils. They fall on the ground and grow into new plants.
Then come to vegetative reproduction. This is not given in your syllabus, but still definition you can learn. Vegetative propagation in artificial vegetative propagation, a portion is detached from the mother plant and then grown independently. And it is usually done for the quick production of the new plants to retain the qualities of mother plant. It is usually done in cutting, layering and grafting. Only this much. Leave this cutting and this whole portion. Earlier it was in syllabus. Now it is not. Mound layering, no need to do this. No need air layering, gooty, grafting. Leave these 2 pages. No need to do this. Micropropagation, tissue culture, it is also not given. Importance you can do. It is not given in syllabus, but still you can do. What is the importance of vegetative reproduction? Vegetative propagation is rapid, easier, less expensive method of multiplying plants which have poor seed viability and prolonged seed dormancy. This is important. And you can micropropagation is used to raising the disease free plants or virus free plants. These are the 2 important things. Limitation: vegetative propagation requires technical expertise, and since vegetative propagation have tap roots, such plants are easily uprooted in storms. And since vegetative propagation does not involve the fusion of gametes, hence the process is not helpful in developing new varieties. No hybrid vigor is there. So these are the disadvantage, or you can say limitation, of vegetative propagation. See, in all these underground stem or in the subaerial stem, how these propagate? Because of the presence of nodes, actually. So these nodes are the site of origin of new plantlets. Because why it is so? Because it contain meristematic cells. And when nodes come in contact with damp soil or water, then like in your pot, then it produces adventitious roots and which further give rise to new plant. Adventitious buds can arise from eyes of potato, rhizome of ginger or banana, or notches present at the margin of leaves of bryophyllum. And this asexual reproduction is common in both plants and animals with simple organization, actually. Whereas asexual and sexual reproduction is common in higher plants. Whereas sexual reproduction generally or is only common in animals. Sexual reproduction only is present on, in animals only. So this is the... See the how these the leaf vegetative parts propagate, because it contain nodes. So nodes are the site of new plant, origin of new plant. Why? Because it contains meristematic cells. So when these nodes comes in contact with deep damp soils or roots or water soil waters, then it produces adventitious roots which produces new plants. What are adventitious buds? From these nodes buds arise. These adventitious buds arise from the eyes of potato, like that these eyes are there, and rhizome of ginger or banana, or notches present at the margins of the leaves of bryophyllum, like that notches present. So these are the adventitious bird which can give rise to new plant. See, this asexual reproduction is common in plants and animals with simple organization, whereas asexual and sexual reproduction is common in higher plants, whereas only sexual reproduction is common in animals. Now come to next part, that is, this is all about asexual reproduction. Now move to sexual reproduction. See, sexual reproduction is, what is sexual reproduction? As we know that sexual reproduction is a type of reproduction which involves the formation and fusion of male and female gametes, maybe of same or different individual with opposite sex, to form zygote, which develops into new organism. So what is written here in the book? Sexual reproduction involves formation of male and female gametes with same or different individual of the opposite sex, and these gametes fuse to form zygote, which helps to form new organism. So this is the exact definition. You can follow this definition or learn this definition. It involves in the formation and by the same individual or by different individual of the opposite sex, and the gametes form zygote, which develops into form the new organism. This is the definition. And most of the animals reproduce sexually. This is important line. Most animals reproduce, and sexual reproduction is energetically okay. Now come to events of sexual reproduction. You know the events of sexual reproduction. Events of sexual reproduction: formation of male and female gametes, then fusion of, first of all, formation of male and female gametes, then pollination, means bringing down male and females together, physically together, come closer so that they can fertilize. The next step is fertilization, which is the most vital or critical event of sexual reproduction. Then formation of zygote, then embryogenesis takes place in that zygote, an embryo is formed, and then it forms a new individual. So these are the steps or events of sexual reproduction. And we know that sexual reproduction is elaborate, complex, and slow process as compared to asexual reproduction. We know that there are various diverse organisms which show similar pattern, but it shows they show similar pattern in sexual reproduction process. All of them produce gametes, all of them syngamy takes place, syngamy is fertilization, and all of them zygote is formed, then embryo, and then new individual. So these are the some points. Then they are telling about the phases. There are life cycle, three phases. You just write here. Three phases. Just write three phases of life cycle of an organism. Of an organism are three phases. Number one, juvenile phase. This juvenile phase is also known as vegetative phase. This is also known as vegetative phase. Then number two is reproductive phase. This is reproductive phase. And the third phase is senescent phase or aging process. Third phase is senescent phase. So these are the three phases. So three phases of life cycle of an organism are juvenile or vegetative phase in case of plant, reproductive phase, and senescent phase. Let now move to next part. It is given the advantage of all organism. From here you underline, all organism have to reach a certain stage of growth and maturity in their life before they reproduce sexually. That period of growth is known as juvenile phase. It is also known as vegetative phase in plants. So this is the definition of juvenile phase. Okay, and this have variable duration. Juvenile phase followed by morphological, physiological changes occur prior to active reproductive behavior. The reproductive phase is also variable. Okay, the end of juvenile or vegetative phase marks the beginning of reproductive phase, which can be seen easily in the higher plants. How you can see in higher plants? Because they have flowering. Due to flowering, if flowering occurs, it means they are in reproductive phase. The annual and biennial plant, which are annual plants, which have only 1 year of their life span. Flowering, everything occurs in 1 year, within 1 year. A biennial, 2 years. 1 year vegetative growth takes place and another year flowering. Clear-cut vegetative, reproductive, or senescent phases. But in perennial, these three phases are not clear. Some unusual flowering phenomena is also there. So unusual flowering phenomena occurs in bamboo species and Strobilanthus kunthiana. These two are there. Strobilanthus kunthiana, which is very important, and bamboo plant. So this bamboo plant flowers only once. You should underline, this is very important thing. Bamboo plant flowers only once in lifetime. And generally after 50 to 100 years and produce a large number of fruits and dyes. This type of plants are known as monocarpic. You can write monocarpic plant. Is type ke plant ko monocarpic plant bolte hain, jo ek baar hi life mein flower karte ho. Then another unusual flowering is Strobilanthus kunthiana. It is also known as Neelkuranji. It is a learning family that grows mainly in the hilly areas of Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and flowers once in after every 12 years. Mass flowering in the hills of Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu into blue stretches, and it attracted various tourists also. Last time it was flowers on earlier it was flower on September October 2006, and last year it was in 2018 September October. Now come to next part. This part is also important in all organism. Both plants and hormones are responsible for the transition between the three phases. Hormones are responsible. Hormones as well as environmental factors. So this paragraph is important. Now come to events in sexual reproduction. So there are three events in sexual reproduction. First of all, pre-fertilization, fertilization, and post-fertilization event. See, in pre-fertilization event, pre-fertilization, gametogenesis, and gamete form transfer takes place. Fertilization, syngamy, where the fusion of gametes takes place. And the last one is post-fertilization, in which zygote is formed and embryogenesis occurs.
So these are the three phases of sexual reproduction. So first one is pre-fertilization events. So this is the definition, all the events of sexual reproduction prior to the fusion of gametes and refer to pre-fertilization events. The gametogenesis and gamete transfer, two process takes place in pre-fertilization event. So these two are main pre-fertilization events. Gametogenesis is the process of the male gamete formation in sexually reproducing organism, and gametes are haploid structures. We know that gametes are always haploid, whether they are parent body, whether they are diploid or haploid, but gametes produced are always haploid. In some lower organism, both male and female gametes are morphologically or similar, they are known as isogametes. You can write the example of isogamete cladophora. Cladophora is one of the algae. You can write cladophora here. When majority of the sexually reproducing the gametes produced are two morphologically distinct types, they are heterogametes. They may be like that male anthrozoid or sperms like that. In human being, it is heterogametes. So now come to cell division or during gamete formation. Which type of cell division takes place? See, gametes, this is also the important topic. Gametes are all heterogametic species are of two types, male and female. The gametes are haploid structure, though the parent body form may be haploid or diploid. The parent body form may be haploid or diploid, but their gamete produced are always haploid. So several organisms of algae, bryophyte have haploid plant body. So, but the members of pteridophytes and angiosperms are most of the, they have diploid. So haploid parent produces gamete by the mitotic division because they are already haploid. So in diploid organism, specialized cell meiocyte cells are present, which are also known as meiocyte mother cells, under which meiosis takes place, so that they form haploid gametes. At the end of reduction, meiotic division, only half of the chromosome get incorporated into each gamete. So come to the, this is also important, chromosome number in meiocytes are diploid 2n and gametes are haploid n in eukaryotic organisms. Some of the examples are also given in your syllabus. These are, in these examples, you have to do onion. No need of doing that name, botanical name, like that Allium sepa. Chromosome number in meiocyte is 16 and chromosome number in gamete is 8. Z maize, 20, 10, rice, 24 and 12. Then potato, 48 and 24. Then ophioglossum, adders or tongue fern, 1260 and 630. Apple, it is 3417. Then in fruit fly, it is Drosophila melanogaster, 8 and 4. House fly, 12 and 6. Honeybee, you can do honeybee, 3216. Cat, 3819. Then human being, 4623. Dog, 7839. Butterfly, 380-190. Rat, 4221. Only this much you have to do. Okay, now come to gamete transfer. We know that after the formation of male and female gamete, both must physically brought together to facilitate fertilization, and in majority of the organism, male gametes are motile and female gametes are stationary. So they need some medium through which these male gametes move to female gamete for fusion. Like that in algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, water is the medium through which the gamete transfer takes place. And large number of male gametes, however, fail to reach the female gamete. So to compensate loss, male gametes are always higher in number as compared to female gametes, so that it can compensate the loss during traveling and compared to the female gametes. And in seed plants, pollen grains carries male gametes. We know that an ovule contain egg. Pollinate produced in anther therefore have to be transferred to the stigma before it lead to fertilization, and the special event is known as pollination. We know that the pollen grain germinates on the stigma, and the pollen tube carrying the male gametes reach to the ovule and discharge the male gamete near the egg, and fertilization process. See, this fertilization process is known as fusion of male and female gametes to produce zygote. We know that fertilization, this is fusion. So transfer of coming together gametes is essential and most critical event of sexual reproduction. The fertilization is the process of fusion of male and female gamete is called syngamy. It is the formation of diploid zygote.
So simple fertilization definition is the process of fusion of male and female gametes which leads to the formation of diploid zygote is known as fertilization. It is also known as syngamy. It is this fertilization is most vital event of sexual reproduction. And then come to the external and internal fertilization. See, fertilization may occur inside the body of an organism or it may be outside the body. If it is outside the body, then it is external fertilization. And if it is fusion of gametes inside the body, female body, then it is known as internal fertilization. So external and internal fertilization, see here it is given in most aquatic organisms, such majority of algae, like in most of the organism, in most of the organism, majority of algae, bony fishes and amphibians like frog, syngamy occurs outside the body, means in water medium. And this type of gametic fusion is known as external fertilization. And this is the characteristic of external fertilization, that they show great synchrony between the two sexes, means both of them, male and female sexes, mature together at the same time. And release of large number of gametes into the surrounding water in order to enhance the chance of gametic fusion. Disadvantages: external fertilization offsprings are externally extremely vulnerable to predators, threatening for survival. Then so the examples are bony fishes and frogs, you can say, or and some algae, majority of the algae. On the other hand, in majority of the plants such as bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms and some higher animals like cartilaginous fishes, reptiles, birds and mammals, gametic fusion takes place inside the body of an organism. This is known as internal fertilization. Since egg is formed inside the female body where they fuse with male gamete, and the male gamete is motile and has to reach the egg in order to fuse it. Hence, large number of male gametes are produced. So why they are large in number? Because in order to compensate the loss of male gametes in between. Or in seed plants, both the non-motile male gametes and female gametes are non-motile. So these male gametes move through pollen tube. So this is about the external or internal fertilization. Come to post-fertilization events. We know the post-fertilization event, the zygote formation and embryogenesis. These are the two post-fertilization events. And we know that a diploid zygote is formed as a result of fertilization. And these zygote is formed, events in sexual reproduction after the formation of zygote are known as post-fertilization. So what are the two events? That is zygote formation, you can write here, zygote formation and embryogenesis. Embryogenesis, these two events are in post-fertilization events. So the process of development of embryo from the zygote is known as embryogenesis. And we know that in flowering plants, after fertilization, ovary develops into fruits and ovules mature into seeds. Inside the mature seed, we know the progenitor of the next generator, that is the embryo, is present. So in animals, the zygote starts developing soon after its formation. Animals may be either oviparous or viviparous, and embryonal protection care is better in viviparous generation. Now move to sexuality in plants. See, sexuality in plants, we know that there are two type of plants, monoecious and dioecious plants. Monoecious plants are those in which both male and female flowers are present on the same plant, whereas the dioecious plant are those in which male plant and female plants are on different body. They are different body. See, monoecious are also, plants may have both male and female reproductive structures in the same plant, bisexual or unisexual. In flowering plant, the unisexual male flower is called staminate and the female is called pistillate. When both male and female flowers present on the same individual, see, underline this, when both male and female flowers present on the same individual, the condition is monoecious. And when male and female flower present on separate or different individuals, they are known as dioecious. Monoecious are also known as homothelic. You can write, monoecious are also known as homothelic. Homothelic. Monoecious are also known as homothelic. Monoecious. And the example of these monoecious are cucurbits, papaya, cucurbits, and coconut. These are the examples of homothallic. Whereas in heterothallic or dioecious plants are those which are male and female flowers on different plants, like that date palm, papaya. These are the examples. So you should learn it. Now come to this sexual reproduction in flowering plants. We know that there are two phases in life cycle of angiosperm: diploid sporophytic phase and haploid gametophytic phase. The plant body which usually develops from the seed is well developed and differentiated into root, stem and leaf. This is known as sporophytic phase. This is the dominant phase in case of angiosperms as well as gymnosperms. Sporophyte produce flowers and these are reproductive structures. Haploid microspore or megaspores are formed as in stamens and carpels by reduction division, the first cell of the gametophytic phase. So you can read this, and the microspores give rise to male gametes and megaspores give rise to female gametes. The gametophytic phase is thus very inconspicuous and extremely reduced in case of angiosperms, where the gametophytic phase is completely dependent on sporophyte and under no circumstances it can be separated from the sporophyte. This is the case of angiosperm, and the diploid zygote formed after the fusion of male and female gamete restore the sporophytic phase. It develops into embryo. The flowers play a very important role in the life cycle of angiosperm. So this whole para, you can read it just. This is not in our syllabus for regarding this chapter. It is not there. Then this is also not there. This micropyle and female gametophyte, embryo sac, this all is not, these two pages are not in your syllabus. This fertilization we have done, endosperm also not in this syllabus. Embryo formation is there. So come to the embryo formation. This is the second part of the post-fertilization event. See this embryo formation. After fertilization, a series of changes takes place into ovule and seed is formed. The fertilized egg zygote develops into the embryo, and the process of development of mature embryo from the diploid zygote is known as embryogenesis. And the dicot embryo has two cotyledons attached laterally to the embryonal axis, whereas the monocotyledonous embryo, the embryonal axis has a single cotyledon at its apex. Then come to formation of fruit. The ovary develops into the fruit after fertilization. Then morphologically, fruit is a ripened ovary. The ovary wall at maturity forms the wall of the fruit, which is known as pericarp. Means fruit wall is known as pericarp. Sometimes the other parts of the flower are also, thalamus also involved in the formation of fruit, like that in case of apple, thalamus is involved. So this is the important, this last line you can underline. There are some external agencies like wind, water, animals, which helps in dispersal of seed and fruits. Now come to sexuality in animals. Like that in plants, sexuality in animals are also more unisexual and hermaphrodites are there. In higher plants, animal sperms are produced in sex organs like gonads and male gonad testes, sperms, female gonad ovary. This you underline. In most of the animals, the like cockles, sexes are separate and the individual possess either testes or ovary. These animals are known as unisexual. It means cockroach is unisexual. But in some animals like earthworm, tapeworm and leech, some same individual carries both testes and ovary. Such animals are known as bisexual or hermaphrodites. So these are the difference between unisexual animal and bisexual animal. Now come to oviparous and viviparous organisms. This whole box you have to do. Animals are categorized into oviparous and viviparous based on whether the development of zygote takes place inside the body of female parent or outside. So when they whether they lay fertilized, unfertilized egg or give birth to young ones, in oviparous animals like reptiles and birds, the fertilized egg covered by hard calcareous shell and laid in the safe place in the environment after a period of incubation, young ones hatch out. On the other hand, in viviparous, majority of the animals, the zygote develops into young ones inside the body of the female organism. And after attaining a certain stage of growth, the young ones are delivered out of the body and female organism. See, embryonal protection and care are better in viviparous organism than oviparous organism. This whole para you have to do. Full para. Okay, now come to parthenogenesis. See, parthenogenesis, when syngamy does not occur, when if syngamy does not take place, then what happens? Then in some cases, in some animals, what happens? This female gamete undergoes directly, without fertilization, undergoes in the development of an individual without fertilization. Then this process is known as
parthenogenesis. See, normally an ovum develop into new individual only after fertilization, but in some cases unfertilized ovum, in some cases an unfertilized ovum may also develop into an individual. This peculiar mode of sexual reproduction in which development of egg occurs without participation of a sperm cell is known as parthenogenesis, without fertilization. And it is natural occurring phenomena occurring in some insects, crustaceans, rotifers, some lizards, platyhelminthes. For instance, like honeybee, the male drone are produced parthenogenetically in honeybee, whereas queen and worker bee develops from the fertilized ova. Then breeds like the white turkey, a type of bird, also found lay eggs which hatch without fertilization. So there are basically three examples: this turkey bird, lizards, and honeybee. In honeybee, male drones are produced parthenogenetically. See, this is the queen, and this queen lay two types of egg. One egg are fertilized by the sperm or male sperm, and another is not fertilized by the male sperm. If this fertilized egg which was fused with the sperm, if fed on the royal jelly, they form queen, worker. If they are fed on honey or bee, they form worker. Whereas if unfertilized egg, then fed on honey and pollen, this unfertilized egg without fertilization get converted into drone. This drone is nothing but male. It is male. See, the queen chromosome number is 32. Then this fertilized egg chromosome number is 16. This unfertilized chromosome number is 16. Without fertilization, it gets converted into a drone, male drone, without fertilization. So its chromosome number is also 16. Fertilization. See here, this queen 32 chromosome, this is fertilized egg, and if it is fused with the sperm of male drone, it also contains 16. So this is fertilized egg, so this worker chromosome number is 32, and this queen chromosome number is also 32. Come to the estrus or menstrual cycle. We know that some animals are seasonal breeders while others breed throughout the... Some animals are seasonal breeders while others can breed throughout the... In birds, they lay egg naturally, seasonally, only seasonally. But in captivity, like in poultry farm, they can mate lay egg throughout the year. So that laying of egg is not related with the... But that type of, in captivity, it is not related with the egg laying process. It is a commercial exploitation for human welfare. See, majority of non-primates like cows, sheep, rat, dogs, deer, tiger, the female receives the male only at certain period of year, and this period is called breeding season for that animal. The sexual activities of the female occurs all cyclically outside these cells. The female do not have any sexual activity. Such a cycle is known as estrus cycle. For example, the sexual activity of the adult bitch occurs only in two seasons in a year. In primates, monkeys, apes and humans, the female exhibit cyclical changes in the activities of ovary and accessory ducts. Such changes in the reproductive phase in them is called menstrual cycle. For example, human females, menstruation is repeated at average 28 to 29 days, and the cycle of event is starting from the one menstruation till one end is known as menstrual cycle. Come to seasonal and continuous breeders. See, many mammals like cows, dogs, especially these whole box you have to do. These two boxes are important. Many mammals like cows, dogs, especially those living in natural condition remain reproductive active throughout the season. Throughout the favorable seasons in their reproduction phase, and such mammals are called seasonal breeders. Seasonal breeders. On the other hand, many other mammals remain reproductively active throughout their reproductive phase and hence are called continuous breeder. Some of them are reproductive only during favorable season, whereas some other are remain reproductive actively throughout their reproductive phase. They are known as continuous. Aging is the prerequisite for natural. The aging process begins after the organism has attained sexual maturity, means at senescent phase, and death is the a last stage of aging, you can say. So this is the end of the chapter. So hope you can understand the whole chapter. Whatever extra points are given, you should remember those points also, because it may come in exam. and do the NCERT question given at the end of this chapter, as well as the last year 2018 and 19 question paper. I am going to show you what type of questions they have asked in the last 2 years. I am going to show you. Just see from 2018, ISC board is totally following CBSC board pattern and syllabus. See, the question paper pattern is also same. 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 3 mark and 5 mark question, and there is no, only internal choices. We will find out how many questions from first chapter. See, first question is also from first chapter. Give a significant point of difference between estrus and menstrual cycle. We know that estrus cycle occurs in non-primates like cow, sheep, goat, whereas menstrual cycle takes place in primates like monkey, human beings, gorilla, like that. Then this question, if the haploid number of chromosome in a plant species is 20, see, haploid is 20. So how many should chromosome should be present in the shoot tip? Shoot tip means plant body. Plant body is diploid. So 2n is equals to 40. Name a plant which flowers only every 12 years. It is Strobilanthus kunthiana. Name the terminal stage of aging in the life cycle of plants. It is senescent phase. So we have seen 4 questions, or it means 4 mark questions are from first chapter. Now come to the next part. Let's see, this question is there. This question is again from the first chapter, that is define lifespan, give the lifespan of an elephant. We know, I've told you, you have to learn that figure given the lifespan, approximate lifespan of some organisms. So lifespan is the period from birth to the natural death of an organism, and it lifespan of an elephant is approximately 60 to 80 years. So this is the next question. Let's find out the other question. I think enough question. They have given 4, 5, 6 marks questions from the first chapter. So I think it's enough. And now there are no questions from it. Already they have given. Now come to the question page. This 2019 question paper. Again the pattern is according to CBSC board. Now let's find out this for 1 mark question. See, what is clone? A group of plants obtained from I have given you the definition of clone, that the morphologically and genetically similar offsprings, your individuals, are known as clones. So this is the exact definition. How many chromosomes are present in myocytes of fruit fly? I have told you, fruit fly, Drosophila melanogaster, how many chromosomes? Myocyte. Myocytes means 8 chromosomes. So these are 2 questions, 2 mark question from the first chapter in 2019 question paper. Again the next question is from the it is next question we can search just it is 5 mark question. See, in 5 mark question they have given 5 questions, 1 mark each. See these 2 questions. What are the seasonal breeders? And give an example. So we know that seasonal breeders are those which are reproductive active in during certain period of time in a year or certain months in a year during whole reproductive phase. And give an example, seasonal breeders like cow, goat, these are seasonal breeders. How is chromosome number maintained in sexually reproducing organism? See, this is again the question. Sexual reproduction, we know that sexual reproduction involves the male and female gametes either through gametogenesis, and these gametes are haploid, and when they fuse they again retain its diploid condition, because the body of the organism, sexually reproducing organism, is generally diploid. So they should maintain the diploid state again due to this gamete formation, and this is by reduction division and by syngamy they again form their diploid condition. So this is the importance of sexually reproducing organisms. So 2 marks from this. So overall 5 marks. We have seen that overall 5 marks questions they have, generally they are giving from the first chapter. If you like this revision of ISC board chapter number 1, reproduction in organism, along with the question paper, answers of the question paper, you just comment and share and subscribe my channel so that you will get the further videos.